his set is? 30? 45?
Probably 40, 45. See if I remember this Ty Siegel code. Just in case. Thank you.
in beating Jimmy. Usually when this happens, they never recover. It's like when Leno beat Letterman.
Yeah.
And it was like that for the next 16 years.
Yeah.
His show, and he's doing weird shit at 10:30.
Yeah.
He really is. And the politics is what's saving him right now. People want to see that.
Yeah.
But he's also doing weird sketches.
Yeah.
Like weird, something like.
He did like an alien thing in Sigourney Weaver.
Oh, he did?
Yeah. I didn't see it, but I heard it.
He's acting like, he does this character that's kind of like Alex Jones, that fucking weird Austin guy.
Yeah.
It's, I don't know. People like it. But I think, I mean, it's not like old people are watching that hour anymore. Well, it is old, but it's like not mom and dad.
I think it's on.
It's like people in their 40s who are around his age
watching
it. Like Letterman and Leno, like old people, like 60s.
Yeah.
And those people are like close to 70. You know, they're not watching that. The new wave of people are watching.
Yeah.
The next generation is watching TV now. And Jimmy Fallon's a faggot.
That sounds harsh.
This show sucks.
No,
he does not interview. He's so awkward.
But he used to do the hip show.
No anymore. He sucks, yeah.
That's not gonna be on TV.
Dave Grohl was on last night.
Uncle Bear.
It was his mom. His mom wrote a book.
Really?
My life, my
son, the rock star.
Yeah, exactly. And she interviews other moms,
yeah,
rock stars, and they talk about, well, they're reading his report card up because she was a teacher and
he dropped out
of high school.
That, yeah.
He had a terrible sixth grade report card. But anyway, they like talk and then they bring up Kurt Cobain and Colbert was like, the first rock star mom that you knew was Kurt Cobain's mom, right? And
Colbert?
Asks the mom. The first relationship, rock star relationship, and she's like, she had to comfort Dave for like weeks after that, and they got all somber. It looked like she was gonna cry.
Really?
Yeah.
I want to see that.
It's just like,
Dave Grohl. Dino Brown dropped out of high school.
I would at least just go get my GED. Well, what's the point, right?
Yeah.
You're a multi-million-dollar.
Well, why did Flea go back to college? And he went to college to study
music. He went to music, though.
Something he. Way proven.
Dave Grohl can't be music, and he can't. It's all about feeling.
Yeah.
But no, that's all good stuff.
The Cities album.
I think that's what that was, right? From the documentary.
I didn't see it all.
No,
every episode is like the same.
What else is on that SoundCloud?
Is that song called Final December?
Yeah, I was, because I was trying to edit, and I had to name a different thing so that I had so many different copies of attempts of trying to edit that song that I had to change the name all the time.
So the song is now called Final December.
I might change it to Back to December. It doesn't matter.
So I made a music video of it and put it on YouTube and I said
it's so loud.
Mm-hmm.
It's too loud. I don't even know about putting it on.
We played
the CD
differently.
Let's try this one. right now, reaping all the benefits. Because, yeah, people move on, and people stop listening to music, like certain kinds of music, and younger generations come, and, you know, you're off the radar.
Yeah.
It happens. It happened to fucking Paul McCartney. It happens to everybody. But then here comes your 50s, 60s, people, it's cyclical, and then people start appreciating you again, and, like, it's just, it sucks. Yeah, the hooks of addiction in him.
A while back, Jessica and I were at Bob's, and Bob showed her the Hope.
Oh,
and
it's sad.
She just was all freaking out. She's like, well, what the hell? Like,
was there?
He's actually,
was
like,
it Corpus? We went to Rooster Street.
Yeah.
Such a small fall.
Like, he was actually like, he actually did that.
He looks sick as fuck. He's all skinny. And like, yeah, it's not a good thing to watch when you're high.
Yeah.
Like, you really get it.
Like,
it's too real. And it's just too, I don't know. Good band. Good fucking band. I would have just let him do what he wanted. Those guys have nothing without him. They tried so many times with different singers, even, you know, the guy from Filter, like, and the guy from Linkin Park. It's just like,
oh, yeah.
I get wanting to play
maybe
your song.
They saw, like, well, Alice in Chains did it, and they're kind of well with that guy still.
That's true.
Yeah,
that's
right.
Interesting. Is Alice in Chains a better band than
well,
SVP?
It wasn't only Lane. It was also Jerry.
That's true. That's true.
Okay. And like that drummer too. That's sick.
Oh, yeah. album together.
Yeah.
By Sub Pop. He was gonna release it. And they went in there and they were like, let's do like Lead Belly stuff. Let's
yeah.
do a blues album together. And they recorded like only 3 songs together, and then they're like, this is not as good as it can be.
It
so they just scrapped it.
Oh, it's so kind of erased it, so.
Yeah, and only 1 song's come out, and it was on Lanigan's first solo album. But, they did Lead Belly. What did you say last night?
Tune in next time for the conclusion of Weekend Corn Dogs. Only on Here Is.
This is our company! It's Tina!